Now it's time to start today's session. So we have with us today's expert, Mr. Devinder Dhawan, who is working as technical manager with Touch Techno Delhi. So before I invite Mr. Devinder to take over the session, so let me briefly introduce about him. So presently, as I told, he is working as technical manager with Touch Techno. He has a total experience of more than 3 years as application engineer, during which he worked with education, private, government and defense sector to promote various products like embedded development and testing tools, data acquisition and analysis tool, PCB designing and testing tools, etc. He has also 2 years of experience as entrepreneur in IoT and system integration domain. He has done his MBA from MIT University and also the PG and UG in electronics from University of Delhi. He has also qualified UGC NET in December 2014, and he is a certified LabVIEW associate developer since September 2015. So he has strong interest in data acquisition and analysis tools, embedded systems, IoT and LoRaWAN technologies, and he is one of the very good expert in the demonstrations of this LiveView, this Multisim Live software. So earlier also we have conducted so many sessions with Mr. Devinder on this particular tool. So today he will be sharing his expertise on Multisim Live tool, which can be used for different purposes or different labs in mainly in ECE related domains. So with this brief introduction, I invite Mr. Devinder to take over the session and start today's lecture.
Thank you for the welcome, sir, and the introduction. Good morning, everyone. As sir has already informed, myself Devinder, and I have some background in electronics and some of these tools like LabVIEW, Multisim Live. And I have worked on various projects throughout my career, and that relates to majorly into IoT and embedded. But yes, data acquisition and the circuit designing is something that is very near to my heart. And that is why I keep on doing all this stuff on site. And today we will look into one of the tools that was launched a few years back by National Instruments, which is called Multisim Live. Now, many of you might be already aware about Multisim, which is an offline tool for circuit designing SPICE simulation. Okay, so this tool, this Multisim Live, is something similar, but it is online. Okay, so it's not an offline tool, it's an online tool, so that no one needs to have a lab, basically have a lab, and they can just do it online. They don't need to install anything on their system. Okay, so that tools gives us more insight, basically more efficiency working wise. Okay, so we will look into the tool also. Okay, 1 second, let me just share my screen first. I hope you all are aware, you all can see my screen now. Okay, if anyone,
yes sir, visible.
Thank you. So if anyone has any problem, let me know so that we can rectify and move forward with it. So as I was saying, that Multisim Live is an online based tool which has a free version also, and it has a paid version also, but most of our exercise can be done using free version also, so we'll not look into the paid version. Okay, so it's very simple to use. I'll walk you through the whole process. Okay, so you just have to search Multisim Live on the Google, open Internet Explorer and search it, and just open the first link and you will land up on this page. Okay, so you obviously might not be having an account here, so you can just sign up for a new account here. You have to give your name, basically your username, your first name, last name, and what role you're playing. You're basically having currently your company, email address, password, and then create an account. it will send in verification email to your mail ID, and that's it. So you will have an account free of cost with this particular platform. Okay, so I already have one. I will just log in that case. So let me just log in. Okay, so once I log in, it will open up my profile here, and you can see that I have 13 circuits designed here. Okay, there are no favorite or no groups I have joined. So basically you have multiple circuits here, which you can see, like public circuits. So it has a very large community, and you can just go into that community and look for any circuit that you're looking for. Most probably someone might have already designed that thing. So you can just simply look for it. Like if I want to search class A amplifiers, I can just search here in the search domain. So you will see class B push pull amplifier, copy of class B, AB is here, then BB. So it will show you the most of the things that is related to what you're searching for. Okay, so I can also search for common emitter amplifier. And you can see here we have multiple amplifier here. Okay, so anyway, this is just an example that you can search for many things here. Okay, so and you can just directly use, like if I use this Wheatstone bridge into circuit, I can just click over it, and this is designed by this person, and this person has this much of circuits designed. Okay, so this is the circuit diagram schematic that you can see here. Okay, so if I click on this open circuit here, it will open up the circuit. Okay, it is initializing it. Okay, so now you can see it has been initialized. So this is the schematic of the circuit which you are seeing here. Okay, if I run this circuit, okay, so it is running right now, and if I click on this graph, so you can see the graph or whatever waveform it is showing, and the waveform it is showing is at this end, the output of the op-amp. Okay, so this is what we are seeing, and we can click here also, and I can see this. Okay, we can try to one second, let me just change some settings here. Yes. So this is like your normal scope only. Okay, so we have this time per division, we have this volt per division also. Okay, so I can give a trigger also here, as you can see here. I can give this trigger, multiple trigger settings are here. Then on which edge, rising, falling, or either edge, we can also specify. And these axes, this is your volt per division auto scaling, and this is your time per division. Okay, so these all things we can change here. So it is acting as in scope only. Okay, so this is somewhat you can say your schematic diagram, your breadboard here on this side, and your CRO this side. Okay, so these are some probes and all which we will try to see. This is just an example which I was trying to show you. Okay, so we will look into how to design such circuits on our own here. Okay, let us just go back. So, you can see this is the first front page that we had. So when we want to start with the new circuit, we will just go here on the create circuit. Okay, so we will just come here. Okay, and it will show us this page. Now you see, I'll first walk you through the options that we have here, then we will go into designing. First is schematic. Now this is schematic, then graph, then split. Okay, so schematic is basically your breadboard, okay, where you will design your circuit. And the graph is the screen of your DSO, as you can say. And split is basically when it will show you both the screen, both of the breadboard and the DSO on the screen. Okay. And then you see some options are here. Interactive, transient, AC sweep, DC op. These are some of the analysis that we can do. Okay, so we can do the AC sweep here, DC op also we can do on the circuit. We can mention the frequency range and it will automatically run the whole analysis and show you the results. That also I will show you later on. Okay. And if you want to see, like if you have given some input and you want to see the output, then we will work in interactive mode. Most of the time we will be working in interactive mode only. Okay. And to run your circuit, you have to click here, but obviously right now nothing has been done, so it will not run. Okay. And this button is for basically stopping the simulation. Okay. Now on the left hand side here, you see some of the components are listed. Like this is analysis and annotation. This is a voltage probe. This is a current probe. This is a probe which can measure both of them. Then voltage reference is there. Some text annotation, then digital probe is there, like 0, 1, it will measure. Then here we have ground connectors and junctions are here. Then we have sources like AC voltage, AC current, clock voltage, all these sources are here. Noise is also here. Okay, so these are some of the sources. Then these are some passive components: resistance, capacitor, inductor, potentiometer, fuse, transformer is here, resistors is here, couple inductors are here. Okay, then we have analog devices like 3 terminal op amp, 5 terminal, and then ideal comparator, 555 IC. And then we have some of the op amp part numbers also. Okay, 741 is the most common one that we use in our labs. Okay, then we have some of the diodes here, diode, normal PN diode, then Zener diode, LEDs here, then general purpose diodes. This particular part number 4148 is also here. Then we have transistors, NPN, PNP with 4 terminal, NPN with 4 terminal, PNP, PNP with 4 terminal, NMOS is here. Then all this JFETs are here, PMOS is here, and then some NPN part numbers are here, some particular part numbers. Similarly, we have PNP part numbers also, one of the part numbers, and then NMOS is also here one. Okay, so basically the part number that you see is an exact SPICE model of the real device. Okay, because all the devices have different specification and their behavior obviously changes as per them. So they have given you these SPICE model of these particular devices only in the free version. Okay, so free version may we have only a few SPICE model only. Otherwise we have the general purpose devices, which also we can basically make specific to some part number. Like if I tell you, this is basically a PNP transistor. Now right now it is a very generic transistor, so if I click double click over it, this window will open up. Okay, so here if you see, you can change the settings, like what is this saturation current, what is this BF point, then NF, VAF, then advanced parameters. All the settings you can change here, and you can make it into an make it into a specific transistor. Okay, so you might be working with some specific part number which is not given in the free version, so you can just take out the spec sheet of that part, that transistor, and you can change all these values here, then this particular transistor will work as that only. Okay, so this is one thing that that you can do. Okay, then sim. Okay, so these are some of the basic optionalities here, which you can see. Okay, so as I was saying that it is not a generic thing. You can make it a specific transistor also. And the same goes with other devices also. Like you can look into op-amp also. A 5-terminal op-amp and then double click over it. And the same thing you can change here. Okay. So that way you, it will act as a particular part number. Okay, then we have some indicators like lamp, LED, 8 LED bar, buzzer is also here. We have some switches also. Okay, this voltage control DPDT is there, current controlled SPST. So all these devices are here. Then we have this modeling blocks also. These are voltage controlled voltage source, this voltage controlled current source. So these different models are also here which you can use for your circuit designing. Then we have electromechanical tools like normal relays here, normally open relay, normally closed relay, combination relay. Machines where we have like DC machine, permanent magnet, DC machine, wound field. So there are multiple things that we have now. This is your motion controllers, angle wrap is here. So I have not used these devices, but yes, we can use that. Now in power, we have linear regulator, LM317 part number is given here. Then under digital, we have digital constant and multiple gates are here. Like under AND, we have two input AND, three input, 4, 5, 6, 7, and 8 input AND, okay. Then we have multiple XNOR, buffer, inverter, all the gates are here. So we can make all sort of digital circuit also, okay. So this is a basic rundown of what we have here, okay. So you can just zoom into in by scrolling, by either clicking here, or maybe, okay. And then maybe you can just use your mouse pad to zoom it and, okay, so this is the basic breadboard that we have. So now first what we'll do, we'll try to understand basic ohms law, okay. And we know that there we will need a DC power source, one resistance, okay. So I will just click over it and you can see that this is coming here, okay. So I will place it here, okay. And what do I need? Nothing. So once I put my this mouse cursor on the terminal here, you see it the terminal is changing from a hand to something like a wire roll. Okay, so once it converts to that, give a single click and then you can see that there is a wire. Okay, so I will just scroll this wire to the next terminal. So it will start doing this beeping thing that you can see on the screen once it reaches some connector. So I will just single click now again and there's a wire. Okay, so now again, I'll go to the other terminal. You see, the wiring tool has come. Single click and then the wire is here. Let me just scroll it. And then we will click again. So this is our basic resistance. So now if I want to change the value of this resistance and maybe this what you can say this voltage source, I can just click over this. I can change the value here, you can see. So I'll make it 10 volt and this I will make, let's say 10k. okay, so I can maybe do this thing also here. Okay, so let me just, I can even copy these devices, like click over this and click on this button, so I will have another device. So if I want to make put another device in the wire here, I will just put over here and the same beeping thing you can see. If I click here, it will be added in the line itself. Okay, so this one I can maybe reduce to 1k. okay, So this is how it is working. Now, obviously, I want to see the voltage drop around these. So what I will do, I will use this voltage probe and I will put one voltage probe here. Okay, so this voltage probe will basically measure the voltage drop between this point and ground. Okay, so obviously now ground also we have to give. So again, this point I will give ground. Okay, so this point and ground, so basically voltage drop across this will be measured, but I want to measure voltage drop across this also. But if I put another probe, let's say at this point, so what will happen, this probe will basically measure the voltage drop between this point and ground, which basically involves this one also. So we don't want that, we just want voltage drop across this resistance. So in order to do so, what we will do, we will go to voltage, and you see there's one probe called voltage reference. So let me click on that. I will put it here. Okay, now what I will do, I will double click on this probe, and you see here voltage reference is ground selected right now. So if I click here, you can see ref one is this one. So basically now it will measure between this point and this point, so that also I can change. Okay, so I can even put multiple voltage references in my circuit. Let's say here, then maybe I can put it put one here also. So you see this is ref 1 and ref 2. So if I come back here now, you can see ref 1 and ref 2 is also here. So if I can basically give a reference at what point I want to measure, between what points I want to measure the voltage. So now this one will measure between this point and reference 1. So that means across this resistance. Then this probe will measure between this point and ground, which is basically this point only. So it is also measuring around this only. Okay, so now if I want to run this, let me just click here. Okay, so you can see that we are getting roughly 9 volts here and 1 volt here, which is accurate because this is 10 volt and this is 10k and this is 1k. Okay, so if I change the reference in between, can I? No, I cannot do that. Okay, so I can even see the graphs, like almost 1 volt is here, then 9 volts is here. I can see the split screen here. Okay, so you can see the graphs are here. So what I can do, I can maybe delete this point and maybe instead use an AC source. Okay, so what will happen if I use an AC source? Okay, so let me just run it now. So, one second. So you can see here, this one is, we are roughly 1 volt only again, and this one is again somewhere around here. Okay, one second, let us just change it to 10 volt. Okay, now here you can see that this one is roughly around, I guess, 9 volts or something. Then this one is roughly around 1 volt. So something similar only, but now we have sine wave instead of a DC. So I can reduce the frequency also. I can change the frequency of our input source here. So you can see that right now it is going from 0 to 1K, but I can increase it also. Like I can make it, I can just type here. Like I can type 1M, which is 1 mega. You can see now. So it has changed to 1 mega. Let me just use my time per division. Okay, so this is what we can do with our frequency source. I can even further increase it or decrease it up to me. Okay. So these are some things that we can do with this voltage. Okay, so this is a basic voltage divider circuit that we have done. Are you guys having any doubt into this? How the system is working and how we are designing all this thing? Are there any doubts in this particular exercise? Okay, so we'll move forward with our session.
Excuse me, sir.
Yes, sir.
Sir, I'm Dheeraj Kapoor from Vyas College of Engineering, doctor.
Okay, sir.
Sir.
Yes, sir.
Sir, can we take the printouts of these waveforms?
You can download these.
Okay.
You can download the
file, lab file for the
student. Yeah, you can take a screenshot also. Like if you see here, you can see export schematic graph or image or graph data. So I can just click on graph data, it will download a .csv file. Or if you want to basically take an image, you can click on these options. Okay, right now I clicked on this graph of data, so it will. One second, my system is running a bit slow. So if I click on, you see this, it has downloaded this file. So if I open it, I will have both the voltage values, sine wave values into this file. Okay. Then if you want to take the photos also, you can schematic, let's say graph or image, I can click. So this also has been done. You can see this, we are getting this image. Okay, then I can also download schematic image, which also is here. You can see the schematic image is also given here. Okay, so this I wanted to open. This is here. One second, let me just show you this data file also. Okay, so let me once again download this grapher data. Even NI has some devices which you can directly connect to this online platform and use some real world data into this. So that also can be done if you have some NI national instrument devices at your college. Now here you can see the data is here. Okay, so this one is time, then this one is your Y data for probe one, this one is again time, with this and this is same, and then this one is your second probe. So if I plot these two here on the Excel also. Okay, 2D chart. One second. Okay, so anyway, it has the data values are too much here. So, because you see, it is a very long data. So, because we ran simulation for only a bit long time, so that is why it is showing a very big data. Okay, so so you can download the data also, and you can take the schematic also for your lab purposes. Okay. So this is one thing. Any other doubts here? I hope I have answered your question, sir.
Thank you, sir. Thank you.
Thank you. Any other questions? Okay, so no questions. So I will just delete all this and we will move toward our next exercise. Okay, so so Ohm's law anyway we have seen. So maybe we can try Kirchhoff law also somewhat. We have seen this voltage law. Okay, so we can try to see this P and IV characteristic Then we have half wave rectifier, full wave rectifier, full wave bridge rectifier, pi rectifier, all these things we can try to make. So we'll start with this one, a normal half wave rectifier, where we have one diode and a resistance. Okay, right now I'll not use this transformer, but we can use that also. I'll show you both of them. Okay, so I need one PN diode. Okay, so if I want, I can take this specific part number, which is 4148. Okay, so I'll take this one, and then I will take one resistance. I will rotate this one and put it somewhere here. Okay, the value is 1k. I will take one AC source to start with. I will take one ground connection. Okay, so now I will just join my circuit. Okay, so click here, move to the next terminal, click again, then click here, and then move to the next terminal, click again. Now this ground I will connect here. Okay, so the frequency that we are giving is, let's say we go till 100 hertz. Voltage, let me give 10 volts. Okay, so diode is this. Now I will need some probes. So this is a voltage probe which will measure the voltage drop across this, at this point, and the ground, which is like across this resistance only. Okay, now this also, and I'll use another probe, this one, which will basically give measure between this and ground, which is my original source, so that you can see both of the input waveform and the output waveform. So now if I run this and I go to graph, let me just you can see that this is rectified. This is basically half wave rectifier circuit. We have already done this, and the negative part of this is already clipped. Okay, so this is a basic half wave rectifier. Now let us just stop this one. If I basically, one second, delete this, and again take this one only, and maybe let's say put it in the other direction. Can anyone tell me what will happen now? What will happen now?
Upper half will be clipped out, I think.
Sorry?
Upper half would be clipped out.
Yes, in this case, the positive cycle will be clipped. In the last case, negative cycle was going getting clipped. Okay, so if I see this, you can see now the positive cycle is clipped. Okay, so I can just, you can see the positive cycle is clipped here. Earlier, the negative cycle was clipped. Okay, so this is the basic half wave rectifier circuit that we can use. Okay, so if I change this resistance value, will there be any effect? A little bit, but not so much. Okay, so just for we can play around with this as we like. We can play around different component values and try to see what is going to be the effect. Let's say if I increase this here, one second. If I increase the voltage, you see nothing. Okay, now you can see that if the frequency is too much, in that case, what is happening? It is full, it is not getting rectified, which is also theoretically accurate, because if the frequency is too much, this diode will not be able to perform its job, and we will get the complete wave out. Now you can see it has been clipped back again. Okay, so this works on the lower frequency only. Any doubts?
So can we change some parameters of diode?
Yes, sir, we can. We can change the parameters if you want to. I'll show you how you can do it. If I double click here, you can see all this model. This one is a model. This one is a generic. This one was not a generic part number that we are using. If you want to do that, we have to take a generic diode. Okay, so let me just connect the circuit first. Okay, then here. Okay, and now I will connect the probes. Okay, so now if I run this, you see the positive edge is coming out here because now it is in the normal position. Okay, if you want to change the parameters of this particular, because earlier one we were using a particular part number which had its own spice model, but this one is a generic one and it doesn't have a particular spice model. So now we can just double click over it. So you can see all these parameters are here, like saturation current is here, ohmic resistance, emission coefficient, breakdown voltage is here, then advanced parameters are also here. This, so these values we can just change and we can work accordingly. Okay, so you can just type the values here and that's it. Any doubts, sir?
No, sir. Thank you.
Okay, so here you can just because this changes will happen on generic devices, not on specific devices, because those specific devices are already coming up with their spice model, which means they are already coming up with all these values inbuilt, because they are some specific devices. And this general purpose device, we can change and we can convert it into any part number we want. We can just download the spec sheet of that part number, and then we can add all these values here, and it will act as that part only. Okay, so this is a great feature, because obviously you understand that in free tools, and not everyone will give you the complete spice model of all the part numbers and all. So this is a great feature which can basically help you create all those parts, part numbers, and work accordingly. But to be honest, the general purpose devices also gives you an idea how devices work and how you can design different circuits and all. Okay, so I guess this one is clear. So this was your half wave rectifier. You can just save this one. Press Control S and you can make it a private circuit or a public circuit. You can give it a name also here and add some description and then click OK. You can add some tags also, like half wave rectifier, diode circuit, so that if people searches by that name, this will come up. Okay, so obviously the private, we cannot make a private circuit because that feature is only for the paid accounts and ours is not a paid account. So we will have to make this public only. So I will just delete this. Any doubts up till now? Okay, so let me just show you this with transformer also. Where is this? Transformer, yes. Here is the transformer. So I will show you the same circuit which you have done up in the last. That half wave rectifier with a transformer. This will also act as same only. Only thing is now we are adding the transformer in between. It should not change how it is working. Okay, so let me just give the connections. Okay, so this will be going here. Okay, and now I will put some probes. Probes I will put here, and then another probe I will put here. Okay, and then the ground connection here. Okay, so I guess this should be okay. 100 hertz and 10 volt is our input. Yes, if I run this now, you see this something similar is happening, but in this case now the voltage is bit the output signal is bit damped because of our transformer. So if I increase the frequency, will it change anything? So you can see the negative cycle is clipped here, but this transformer has made some changes here, which is transformer's property only, so that should be okay. Okay, so this is again same thing. Now we will move toward our full wave rectifier, and let us just try to design this one. With pi circuit. Okay, you can try to make any alteration that you want. Like we have the basic bridge type circuit also, then we have a pi circuit also added in between, so that all we can try to see. Okay, so I will make the pi circuit directly so that we can save some time and maybe design some more circuits also. So let me just take a voltage source. I will need four diodes, 1, 2, 3, and another one here, 4. Okay, so let me just connect these. Okay, and then yes. This will be connected like this in the middle here, and then this one will be connected in the middle here. Okay, now we will take a ground connection. Okay, so now what do we need? We need a capacitor, inductor, and another capacitor. Capacitor is here. Okay, we need two capacitor. We need one resistance. Then we need one inductor. Okay, so let me just make some space for these devices also. So you can just drag these devices like that to make space for another devices also. Okay, so. Even the wires we can move like that. Okay, so now we will need these. Two of these are in parallel like this. Inductor would be here. And then we will have this resistance in the last, across which we will measure our resistance. Oh, sorry, voltage drop. Okay, so the connection of these are like this. Let me just make the connections here. is connected here. And then this end is connected at this end. Okay, now we will put a ground here. Okay, so the voltage that we will use is 100 hertz and 10k. Okay, resistance, capacitance and resistance value will keep same for timing. We'll try to change the values and see how they are working. So this is one voltage, another voltage measurement we will do across this. Okay, so let us just run this. Okay, so now you can see that what is happening in this. Okay, so if I go back here, sorry, and try to change the values, you can see the differences on the waveform. Okay, so if I try to change this also, not much effect is happening. If I change this value again, okay, so you can see it is reducing again, and this resistance value is also adding up to the change. So you can see we are trying to reduce the ripples here. So you can try multiple combinations here. And obviously we can try to put in some specific part number of the diodes to see a more accurate result as per the specification. Okay, so now this is something that we are getting. So you see we have converted that into DC with some ripples, and we can try to add another circuitry in front of it to basically make it more smooth. Okay, so now you can just maybe save 1 second. Stop it, and then we can save it as per we want, schematic image, grapher image, or grapher data as per you like. Okay, so I don't want to save it, I already have this circuit saved. So any doubt in this? Are there any doubts? Here,
excuse me, sir.
Yeah, tell me, sir.
Sir, can we search the components?
Can we?
Search. We have search option.
Yes, sir. Here. I can just search diode. It will show me diode, and I can click here, and I can put it here.
Thank you, sir.
Okay, so I can search for anything that is here. Maybe a resistance. Maybe I have made some spelling mistake here.
Sir, we have ICs also.
So which ICs you're looking for?
Like op-amp 741.
Yes, sir, we have op-amp. We have a generic 3-terminal op-amp, 5-terminal ideal comparator, 555 IC, and then we have these two, LM324A or UA741 IC here. Anyway, I'll be going to use this now. I'll be going to use these ICs also, so we'll look into it.
Thank you.
Okay. So no doubt on this, we'll move forward. Okay, so this was the basic things that we can do with this, and now we will look into some other circuitry which add electronics lab. So we can try to make some basic amplifiers also, like common emitter. So I will try to make this one now, common emitter amplifier. Okay, so what do we need for this? A basic NPN transistor, or maybe we can take a particular part number, but I will go with a basic NPN transistor. Okay, and what components do we need? 4 resistance, 2 capacitance. Okay, so let us just put these on our schematic. 4 resistance, then we will need 2 capacitance. Okay, Okay, we will need one voltage source also that I'll give later on. So, okay, the circuit is somewhat, we need a voltage source plus VCC also. Let me just get that. Where is our voltage source? DC voltage. Okay, so what we will do, we will give, let's say 10 volts. Okay, another end of this will be connected to a ground. So we'll move it. Let's keep it here for time being. We'll need another this, then we will need one input signal, which will be this. We can, I can even change the name. Vin. I can even change the name of this one here also. VCC. Okay, so these things also we can change, like RL or something like that. Okay, R1, R2, R3, whatever we want. Okay, so let us just try designing our circuit now. Okay, so now we will just need probes. What is this one? We will measure at this point. Let me just put it here and get another resistance. So I will measure the voltage drop across this. Okay, so let me just run this. Decrease the frequency a little. Okay, go to the graph. Okay, so you can see this is the input and this is the output waveform. Let us just try to change some values to see what maximum result we can get. Because anyway, we have not done any calculation prior to designing this circuit. That is why our result is a bit not exactly as per we wanted. But anyway, we will do the hit and trial method here to get the results. Okay, we can do one more thing. One second. Let us just run the AC sweep so that we can understand the bandwidth of this particular circuit. So you can see the blue one is our. So what it will show is the frequency range and the different value. Like this green dotted is our phase of input. Okay, then this is our voltage of input voltage. Input voltage is this, then this is our output voltage, and this one is output phase. Okay, so we can see that as per this graph, our output voltage will never cross this, the input. So this will not be doing any amplification, so we need to change the values and see how it is working. Okay, the maximum gain that we can get is between 199 hertz, roughly 125 hertz to 5k is what our maximum gain is. Okay, so let us just try to use let me just see if I have another circuit already made. Circuits, my circuit class AB, NPN, common collector, common emitter amplifier. This one should be the same circuit. Yes, so now we are using some particular part number also, and some particular values also we are using here. So if I run this one, you can see the input is output is more than the input. Okay, and if I run the AC sweep which is on this particular thing. Let me just remove the phase. Okay, so you can see between this frequency, which is 500 hertz to roughly this is 10K. My output would be more than the input. Okay. So this is 500 hertz to 10K. Let us just try to see that. Okay. So now you can see the input frequency. If I reduce, frequency. Okay. So if I reduce my frequency below 500, you see my my output is a blue one. It has reduced. It is less than the input wave. So let me increase it. So after 500, it is more than the input. So amplification is happening, and it is saying that it should go till 10K. Okay, so after 10, it will again reduce back. Okay, so you can see that as we are approaching 10, it has started coming down. Let me just adjust the time division or time per division. Okay, so as we reach 10K, it has started coming down. And if I reduce further, this is voltage. If I increase it further, you can see that it has again decreased. It is less than the input voltage. So we can check our bandwidths also using. We can do the AC analysis using this also. Okay, so roughly we can just run the AC analysis on both phase and magnitude. Okay, we can change the values and we can try to see the different result also, because obviously the bandwidth will depend upon the component value also, like we have seen here. Like the circuits are same in both the case, but you can see the values are different. Hence, we have different different responses on our frequency AC sweep analysis. Okay, so this is what we can do with this particular tool also. Okay, so you can see that it has surpassed here only, and then it will decrease. Okay, so as per this, you can even change the frequency range on which you want to run the analysis, and logarithmic scale or linear or decibel or octave scale, what you want to use to plot the data. That would be as per your liking. You can see this is the linear scale. Okay, so you can see here the same thing is happening, like from 500 hertz till 10k is what our bandwidth is. Okay, so these things you can try to see. Any doubt in this? Are there any doubts? Okay, so if there are no doubts, I will move forward. Okay, and the next circuit that we will do is we'll use some op-amp IC and try to make some other circuitry using op-amp also. Just give me a second. Okay, so yeah, this one is okay. Let us just go back. Okay, so now this was the one we were doing. Okay, Control A, delete. So now we will try to make some op-amp circuits. So you can even make common base, common collector, then different classes of amplifier also you can try to make. Okay. Even you can make the digital circuits also. We have done that in our trainings earlier. So these things also you can try. Flip flops and your MUX circuits are there. Full subtractor, half subtractor are also there. These things you can try. Then we have which lab? Op-amp lab, where we can do differential basically this inverting, non-inverting, current to voltage converter, op-amp competitor. Okay, and then this integrator is there. Okay, low pass, high pass circuits are here. We will try to make this low pass, high pass circuit. And then also what you can do, then you can also, okay, no, this one is different. Okay, so what we'll do, we'll try to make a basic op-amp circuit, non-inverting amplifier first. Okay, so this is how the non-inverting amplifier would look like. So let us just go back. One second. Okay, so we will take one basic op-amp. A 5-terminal op-amp is what I will take. Okay, or maybe if you want, I can take the 741 IC. Okay, so okay, now okay, so we need 3 resistance here. Let us just get 3 resistance. Okay, we will need one ground, we will need one AC signal. Okay, and then obviously we will need one DC voltage to power this. To power this op-amp. Okay, so what I will do, 15 volts is what we will give here. And this one I will give -15. Okay, so something same we will something similar we will do here also. Okay, so we have given the biasing from plus to minus 15. Then our input signal is this one, which will go here. Okay, then we have one resistance here. Okay, and this will also come to the ground. I'll just check if we have done the same. Okay, I guess we are good to go. So let me just put some voltage probes here and one here and now run. Okay, so we are doing AC sweep. So you can see here we have our non-inverting amplifier working perfectly. Okay, so we can make an inverting amplifier also with this circuitry. Okay, so this was a basic thing. Now let us just try to make some first order low pass filter. Okay, so this is the circuit that we will be making. Okay, so this will have one. So here we will have, I guess, only one resistance and one more RC circuit here. Let me just make some space. Okay, so one resistance we will copy, put here. Okay, then we will need one capacitor. Put here, rotate it. Okay, so now can anyone tell me some particular values using which we can get some cutoff frequency? This is a circuit, na? Yes. Can anyone tell me some values? Okay, anyway, let us just run some AC sweep over it. So you can see that till this particular value it is passing, after that it is not passing. So our cutoff would be somewhere on this 794 kilohertz. So roughly 800 hertz we can take. Okay, so after this our signal is getting attenuated. Before this our signal is more than the input signal only. Okay, so if I make some changes, let's say increase or decrease this, increase this value, let's say. Okay, now if I run the AC sweep, I don't need face. So now, I guess same thing is here. 1 second. Now also we're getting same thing only. Let us just look 1 second. So I guess the formula is 1 over 2 pi RC. Yes? Correct me if I'm wrong. This would. Okay. Okay, so so blue one is our output. So right now you see we are getting the signal is getting passed. Okay, so let us just try to see. Okay, I'm increasing. So you see the signal is attenuating now. Okay. So these things we can try to make here. 1 second. Okay, so let us just try to change the frequency now. Adjust time for division. Then increase it further. So you can see, I guess, some designing issues we have done here. But I guess you get the idea how the system is working. Okay, so this is basically our low pass, and similarly, we can make our high pass circuit also. This is low pass, then high pass is somewhat like this. Then we have band pass also, we have band stop also. So these things we can try to make. So there are multiple things that can be done here. And obviously you can go for a bit high-end circuits also, and some communication circuits and normal differential amplifiers, multiple classes of amplifiers. So you can try to cover your basic electronics lab, advanced electronics, communication, op amp lab, digital lab. All these labs can easily be done using this particular tool. And I hope I was able to give you some basic idea about it. And if you have any doubt, maybe you can let me know. Otherwise, we can stop for the session today.
Excuse me, sir.
Yes, sir.
Sir, can we join or connect the different circuit files? Suppose I have a project in my lab and I assign that particular project. First, I divide the project into four segments and I assign one segment to each student. So later on, can I connect these files?
So we can. I have to check on that if different files we can connect, but somewhere we can try to like on the same circuit, I can copy and paste these circuits, but I need to check if that file connections can be done.
Okay.
Which I doubt might be the case.
We can copy the circuit.
Yeah, we can copy those circuit, paste it in a single file and then connect them.
That will fulfill our purpose.
That we can do.
Thank you, sir.
Okay. Any other doubts?
Hello.
Yes, sir.
Good afternoon, sir.
Good afternoon, sir.
Sir, I'm Kapil Tyagi from DNA Protecting Meerut. Sir, okay. Actually, my branch is mechanical engineering. So your lecture was very nice, and even I am from mechanical engineering, I understand a lot of things from this lecture.
Yes, sir.
But sir, when you provide the assignment, then consider us also, because we all know thing, but all these things, but we are not able to make the circuit because of some branch issue.
Okay.
So please, when you provide the assignment,
I'll keep that.
It must be simple. Thank you. Thank you.
Yes, sir.
Sir, are there any such tools for networking, computer network kind of simulations or works, sir? Online tools?
Sir, I have no idea about that. But I can check if you want. Networking, I will check, sir.
Thank you, sir.
Any other doubts?
Dear participants, the session is open for questions. If you have any question, kindly please unmute your mic and then you can directly ask, sir.
Good morning, sir.
Good morning.
Sir. Actually, I just wanted to know, can we add the parts from our side, or are there libraries that we can import? This is my first question. And the second question is, for like a PCB designing using this particular software tools?
Sir, not this one. Like first question is, you want to use some particular parts. That is what your question is.
Yes, additional like, part, like if I wish to go with the some ICs like related to the hybrid electronics ICs like 74160 counter ICs and others.
Okay, so you are saying the parts that are not available here.
Yes.
So in the free version, that option is not here.
Okay, sir.
But on the paid version, it should be there. You can add any SPICE model.
Okay.
And the second question was, sir?
Related to the PCB designing. Now, if I...
PCB designing, no, this is just the software simulation, circuit simulation part.
Okay.
NI has some tools for PCB designing, like they have multisim and the ultiboard tool.
Okay.
So multisim, you design your circuit, you test it, and then you directly export it to Ultiboard, where basically you design the PCB files of it, out of it.
So
but both of these tools are offline and they're paid.
Okay. So there is no alternative for the PCB, small PCBs like this?
So you can use Eagle. I guess we have session coming up for PCB surely, designing sir. Also later on.
Yes.
So Eagle is a tool that you can try to use.
Okay, great. Thank you, sir. Thank you so much.
Okay, sir.
Sir, this is the free version, as you told. The full version is paid.
Yes, sir. Because you see, there is not SPICE model of every other component, and we were using the generic parts only. And though we can make those generic into specific parts, but yes, this is a free version, and you don't have the complete SPICE model set.
Okay. Yes, dear participants, any more questions?
you can even see the difference between the free subscription and the premium subscription. If you get the premium account, you can include the multi-sim for desktop also, like you will get the offline tool also. Components per circuit here are 25, then there is unlimited, then component libraries basic and advanced is here. Simulation type, like we had AC sweep, transient, interactive, and DC op. There you have six also. Then edit model is also here. Add free access, private files, export to multisim. And there are a few more things that you can go and learn here. And if you want, you can just contact NI for National Instruments for pricing of these tools also.
Sir, how much is cost for education institution?
Sir, I have no idea about that, but it should but I guess for your basic purpose this free version should be more than enough.
Okay, sir. Thank you.
Any tool for online hot potato version, sir? Kyunki hot potato, we need to install it in Windows system. I'm using Linux system.
Sir, hot potato I have never used, so I'm not fully aware about that.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
But I can check on that if there's any thing.
Bharat sir, you can always write a mail to Srinidhi sir. I'll share the email address in the chat box.
Thank you, sir.
So, dear participants, any more questions? Devinder sir has kept the session open for questions right now. So, if we do not have any questions, then we'll break. We'll have a break for 30 minutes. Any more questions, dear participants? Yes, Garima ma'am.
Nothing.
Okay, so maybe we can, if there are no queries, we can stop the session.
Yes, over to you, Garima ma'am.
So I think there is no query.
Yes.
Yeah. So I would like to thank you, Mr. Devinder, for such a nice session on this multi-sim.
Thank you, ma'am.
Our participants will get benefited from this.